Good morning to everybody. I welcome to all of you in video lecture series through BISEC. I hope that you will learn and enjoy the same. Myself, R.R. Patel, lecturer in mechanical engineering, RC Technical Institute, Ahmedabad. For giving opportunity to our team, I am very much thankful to Commissioner of Technical Education, Gandhinagar, for giving opportunity for sharing knowledge and experience of our team with you. Now, today is the first lecture, so I will introduce the subject engineering drawing. Then I will try to introduce the different topics that is included in these subjects, and I will also explain some important terminology related to the subjects so you can thoroughly understand the subjects very well. First of all, we will switch over to our PPT presentation. Now our subject is basic engineering drawing, title of subjects. GTU defined code is 330007. Now interpretation of this code also I will tell you. First digit 3 is indicate the version of curriculum. Then second 3 digit is the diploma program. Then third digit will show you the semester. This is the common subjects in all engineering branch. So zero digit is there. And then two digits for the branch code. And last two digit is the code for the subject. 07 is the code of engineering drawing subjects. So this is the interpretation of code of the subjects. Now these are the various branch in which this subject is offered. In first semester, all branch: automobile engineering, ceramic engineering, civil engineering, environmental engineering, mechanical engineering, mechatronic engineering, metallurgical engineering, mining engineering, printing technology, textile manufacturing technology, textile processing, and transportation engineering. These all branches in first semester learn the subject engineering drawing. In second semester, this subject will be offered in chemical engineering, electrical engineering, fabrication technology, and plastic engineering. So this is the basic subjects related to basic principles of drawing, which is useful to almost all branch of engineering. Now, first of all, I will introduce the list of the topics that you will have to study in this particular subject, basic engineering drawing. First topic is engineering drawing aids. That means the instruments and materials and equipments we are using for drawing the manual drawing. Second topic is planning, layout, and scaling of the drawing. That is related with available space in the drawing, how to plan so that we can utilize the whole working area of the sheet for the drawing purpose. So we'll have to select the proper planning and proper layout. Also, we will have to select the proper scale for the drawing purpose. There are basically two types of scale: full scale 1:1, then reducing scale. Suppose we want to draw the figure of a building, drawing of building, then we will take the reducing scale. So it is represented with small dimension in the drawing, that is called reducing scale. Then we can choose the enlarging scale for drawing the small object like watch. These are very small objects, so we can take the enlarging scale for representing that type of object in the drawing. Geometrical construction. Basically, in engineering drawing, basic geometrical entity are points, lines, circle and arc. And there is so many constraints related to each. So we can produce this entity with a given constraint like parallel, perpendicular, concurrence, intersecting, tangent. So these are the constraints, and we can represent all these entity with constraint in geometrical construction. Then next topic is engineering curves. Conic section, most probably, when we are cutting the cone in at different sections, we are getting the conic section. So it is applied at different application, the conic section. So different types of conic curve, like ellipse, parabola, hyperbola, involute, cycloid, we will learn in engineering curves. Then projection is very important. I will show you the theory of projection next PPT. So simple drawing entity, I already tell you. Point is a no-dimensional entity. Line is having one-dimensional entity. And plane is two-dimensional entity. So how to draw the projection of these objects in engineering drawing, that will be studied in these topics. Then next topic is orthographic projection. Orthographic projections is 2D drawing. How we representing 3D objects, actual 3D objects in 2D drawing. That principle we will study in this topic, orthographic projection. Isometric projection is a 3D drawing where object itself represented in 3D view. So it will require only single view for drawing purpose, and it visualizes the objects. So in that topic we will see how to draw the isometric projection. So these are the introduction of different topics that we will have to study in this particular subject. Now here I will introduce the subject teaching scheme and examination scheme. Particularly in these subjects, for week we are having two lectures. There is no any tutorials, and for our practice. From this teaching scheme, I can say that this subject is more related to practice work. Without practice, no student can learn anything. So you will require lot of practice for drawing with the help of instrument. Then and then you will study these subjects thoroughly. Total credit is sum of lecture, tutorial and practice. So it is the 6 credit. When you will pass these subjects, you will get 6 credits. Then examination scheme. There are two parts, theory parts and practical parts. Theory parts, 70 marks for end semester exam and 30 marks for 30 marks for progressive assessment during the term. Similarly, for practical also, end semester exam is having 40 marks and progressive assessment, that the you do the practice in the term work, that will include 60 marks. So practical is having also equal weightage in these subjects. So total 100% theory marks and 100% practice marks in particular these subjects. Now I will introduce the subject experts. who will contribute their knowledge and experience for sharing with you. First of all, myself, R.R. Patel, convener. I am from RCTI, Ahmedabad. Second, our experts is Dr. Atul Shah from Gandhi College, Surat. Third expert of our subject is Professor Niyaz Mansuri from Government Polytechnic, Gandhinagar. And fourth expert, Professor Chirag Shah from Government Polytechnic, Ahmedabad. And last expert, Professor Nisha Prandya from Government Polytechnic, Ahmedabad. Now I will introduce the subjects. What is the importance of subjects? So engineering drawing is an effective graphic language in engineering to communicate and convey the ideas, layout, plan to technical persons like foreman, technician, turner, supervisor, engineers, those persons who are related with technology. It is very convenient to convey shape, size, and other features completely as well as concisely of the object with the help of engineering drawing, as world languages are inadequate for describing the particular object. Picture drawing is worth 1,000 of words, so no one can describe completely the object with the help of words. So this is the importance of drawing in engineering application. It is a foundation block which strengthens the engineering and technological structure. Without drawing, production is not possible, updating is not possible. Drawing are the roadmaps which show how to manufacture the products and structures. Knowledge of ED will increase the productivity in industry and manufacturing and effectiveness in engineering application. Engineering drawing can be used in different fields like production field, ship industry, then also construction industry. So these are the variety of field where the engineering drawing is used. Now after studying these subjects, what competency created in the students, that I will show you. You can prepare the engineering drawing manually with geometrical dimension using the standards and drawing instruments. So you will be aware with different instruments and different international standard, Indian standards, and with the help of this, you can draw perfectly the manual drawing. You can visualize the shape of simple object from orthographic views and vice versa. So this is also important. In drawing, we are representing 3D objects with 2D drawing in the paper. So with the help of knowledge of these subjects, you can create the image of 3D objects with the help of 2D drawing and vice versa. Now, methods of engineering drawing. There are basically two methods. One is manual drawing. We are preparing the drawing with the help of instruments. And another is computer-aided drafting and design. Means we are using the package software in the computer for drawing the drawing in AutoCAD software. There are so many advantages of CAD drawing. Computer has a major impact on the method used to design and create technological drawings. You can edit the drawing. You can store the drawing in soft copy also. You can duplicate the drawing. Then you can analyze the drawing. You can link the drawing. So everything is possible in CAD drawing. You can do the 3D modeling also. There are so many advantages. It is also cheap and less time consuming. Though manual drawing is having equal importance. Because without knowing the fundamental principles of drawing, you cannot effectively use the CAD software. So basic knowledge of manual drawing is essential. Then and then you can use effectively the CAD drawings in computer software. Basic knowledge of drafting. In a drawing or drafting, there are two contents. One is graphic language and other is word language. In graphic language, major portion is geometrical construction. We can show the different simple entity like point, line, arc, circle, and their constraint with the help of geometrical construction. Second entity, projection method. We will have to select the correct projection method. We will see what are the different projection method and theory of projection later on. Also, we will study, there is one topic on geometrical construction. So also we will see what are the basic themes in geometrical construction also. And line types. What are the different types of line? That is also one separate topics for types of line. We are using the different types of line for representing the different drawing entity. So that we will study in graphic language. Then another is word language, where we are giving the lettering and dimensioning to the drawing. That will show the shape and size of the drawing. We can label the drawing. And we can put some note or instruction on the drawing with the help of word language. So word language is supporting to the graphic language. Then and then we can complete the manual drawing. Then projection is very important word. In most of the topics we will see the words projection. So we should know what is the projection theory and meaning of projection. So basically, there are two types of projection, perspective projection and parallel projection. In parallel projection, line of sights are parallel to each other. So it is easy to draw the parallel projection. In perspective projections, the line of sight are inclined and meeting at a one point. So object will looking distant in perspective projection. Most of the architecture drawing and building drawing, we can use the perspective drawing. Our image in the eye is the perspective drawing. And that is give more clarity to the object in perspective drawing. In parallel drawing, there are two types of drawing, oblique drawing and orthographic drawing. In oblique drawing, line of sight is inclined to the plane, means oblique, it is having some angle. And in orthographic drawing, the line of sight is perpendicular to the screen or plane. So ortho means perpendicular. So in parallel projection, there are two types. One is oblique projection and another is orthographic projection. Oblique projection is very difficult to draw. So we will concentrate on orthographic projection. Now in orthographic projection, there are two types. One is axonometric, or it is called isometric, and another is called multi-view projection. In multi-view projection is a 2D drawing. So we will require more than two views in multi-view drawings, and one of the face of the object is kept in the front of the observer. So we can see at a time two dimension of the objects. So for complete description of the object, we will require more than two view. So it is called multi-view projection. In axonometric drawing, we are positioning the object in relative to observer in such a way that we can see all three dimension in one view. So it is a 3D drawing represented in 2D plane. So it will give the complete picture of object because it is 3D drawing. So we are using this axonometric means isometric drawing and multi-view drawing in our subject engineering drawing. Projection theory is used to graphically represent all 3D objects on 2D media like paper or computer screen. How to represent the 3D objects on 2D plane like paper or computer screen? That theory is called theory of projection. Theory of projection is based on two variables. When we want to draw the projection of any objects, we will require four elements of projection: object, one element, another element is observer, third element is line of sight, fourth element is plane of projections, or it is called screen or image plane or picture plane. And as a result of this element, we are getting the projection of the object on the plane of projection. So important two parameters in theory of projection is line of sight and plane of projection. There are two types of line of sight. Line of sight is the imaginary ray of light between an observer, eye, and the objects. So this is called the line of sight. It is imagination, imaginary rays. There are two types of line of sight: parallel and converse, means non-parallel. Parallel projection, we are using the parallel line of sight. Line of sight are parallel in parallel projection. And in perspective projection, line of sight are meeting at one point, means converse at particular point. So line of sight is parallel in parallel projection and line of sight converging in perspective projection. Plane of projection is an imaginary plane on which the image is created, means projection we are getting on the plane of projection. Images is produced by connecting the points where the line of sight pierces the projection plane. That we can see from the figure. In parallel projection, this is plane of projection, and the line of sights are piercing on the plane of projections, and we are connecting the piercing point in sequence, so we are getting the projection of objects on the plane of projection. Here we are using parallel line of sight. In perspective projection, this is also plane of projection, but line of sight are converging and piercing point with the plane of projections we are joining, and we are getting the projection on the plane in perspective projection. So this is the basic difference between parallel projection and perspective projection. Orthographic projection is the types of parallel projection. But here the line of sight are perpendicular to the projection plane. Ortho means perpendicular. Here we can see the line of sights are perpendicular, means right angle to the plane of projection. All line of sights, five line of sights, are perpendicular two plane of projections, and we are getting the projection on the plane. So that is called orthographic projection. We are getting here the 2D drawing of the 3D objects. Isometric or axonometric drawing. Advantage of this drawing, it is a 3D drawing, easy to understand because we can see the three-dimensional in one view. So non-technical persons like customer or non-technical person can also understand very well the 3D drawing or isometric drawing. But disadvantage, there is a distortion in the shape and angle. Here 90 degree angle is not 90 degree, it is the obtuse angle, means larger than 90 degree, and circle is converted into ellipse. So this is the distortion of the shape, and this very difficult to draw the 3D object, that is time consuming. So that is the disadvantage of the isometric drawing. Multi-view drawing, major advantage of multi-view drawing that it represents accurate shape and size and easy to draw as it is 3D drawing. It is very easy to draw the multi-view drawing, but major disadvantage of multi-view drawing is it is very difficult to interpret. Technical person can interpret, who is having the knowledge of engineering drawing can interpret the multi-view projection. So technical persons can interpret this drawing, multi-view drawing. Non-technical persons cannot interpret the multi-view drawing. It is a 2D drawing. Same objects that we have shown previously in 3D view in isometric drawing, same object we have seen here in 2D drawing, and it will require minimum two view for completely describing the shape, size and features of the original objects. Here we can see that it is very difficult for the non-technical person to visualize the shape of these objects from this 2D drawing. Now this is the design process. We want to design any products, then these are the basic steps which will require to design any products. So here design and sketch and drawing portion is related to our engineering drawing. So we should know what is the impact and level of knowledge of engineering drawing in our design process. That will show with the help of this flow diagram. Now, I will teach you the first topic, and title of first topic is Engineering Drawing Aids. Aids means instruments, materials, and equipments with the help of which we can draw the engineering drawing. That is called aids. That is means supporting, sahayak. In this topic, we will study the different equipments, their types, their specification, how to use them properly, and what is the real application of that equipment. Then we will study also different instruments, types of instruments, their description and specification, and method to use them properly, and the application where they are applied. Then different grade of pencils, their applications, then types of their leads, points, and then proper application of different types of lead that we'll see in that particular subtopics, and other related material, that is the auxiliary material that will require for drawing manual engineering drawings. We'll see the different materials and their real application. So this is the content of first topic, engineering drawing aids. This is the major outcomes, learning outcomes. After studying this first topic, student will be able to use drawing equipment, instruments and material effectively for drawing the manual engineering drawing. So this is the major learning outcomes that will be achieved by study of this first topic, engineering drawing aids. Now I will give the short introduction to this engineering drawing aids topics. Engineering drawings are prepared with the help of set of drawing instruments. There are different types of instruments, we will see one by one. But accuracy and speed of drawing, then draftsmanship largely depend upon quality of instruments. So it is essential for every student to procure the instruments of good quality, because speed, accuracy and drafting is largely depend upon the quality of instrument we are using for drawing the particular engineering drawing. So it is very important to have the good quality of instruments. These are the list of different engineering drawing aids. First is drawing board, then mini rafter or drafting machines, then T-square, parallel straight aids, set squares, then protector, then scales, then roll and draw, then drawing instrument box that contains the lengthening bar, large size divider, large size compass with interchangeable legs, small bow compass, small bow divider, then small bow inking pen, then inking pen. These are the instrument which is available in drawing instrument box. Then circle master, then different drafting templates, then French curves, then stencil for lettering and dimensioning, then drawing paper or drawing sheet, then drawing pencils having different grades for different works, then pencil sharpener, then eraser or rubber for erasing unwanted lines, then rubber seal, drawing pins and clips, then sandpaper blocks for sharpening the leads of the pencil, then drawing paper box, or it is called container, then duster or handkerchief, waterproof blank ink, and the last one is sketchbook. So these are the different instruments, equipments and materials we will require to draw the effective engineering drawing. We will see one by one. First is equipment, is drawing board. Now top surface of the drawing board should be plain and free from crack to support the drawing stick, so that it will be convenient for drawing purpose. It is rectangular in shape and made up of strips of well-seasoned soft wood about 25 mm thickness. It is supported at the back by two battens supports to prevent the warping of the drawing, means to making the board durable for long time. Left edge of the drawing is the working edge. It is fitted with ebony working edge in rectangular groove that will provide straight, true and durable guide on which our T-square will slide on it. Drawing board is available in different size, so depending upon the size of sheet, we can use the size of drawing board. These are the different sizes available according to Indian Bureau of Indian Standards suggested in 1444/1989 version. So in first column, it is the designation of particular drawing board B0 that is having size 1000 mm by 1500 mm, and name is called antiquarian. Second designation of board is B1, that is smaller than B0, size is 700 by 1000 mm. It is called double elephant. Then third size is B2, size is 500 by 700 and it is called imperial board. Next is B3 board, size is 350 by 500. It is called half imperial board. And last is B4 designation of board, and size is 250 and 350. It is called quarter imperial. So this is the different size of board available according to IS. The mini drafter, it is a one instrument which will replace, use an advantage of T-square, Z-square, scales and protector. We will see what is the T-square, Z-square, scales and protector in next PPT. But this one instrument is replacing four minor instruments. Advantage and use is replaced by this one instrument. So with the help of this mini drafter, or it is called drafting machines, we can draw accurate drawing with a great speed. Mini drafter is having, we can see from the figure, variety of removable scale or blades we can use as per the requirements. Here we can say these are the blades, and this blade is can be replaced and used according to our requirement. So we can use the different blade or scales according to our requirement. Scales will remain parallel to original position wherever they may move on the drawing board. We can see here, if you will move this scale anywhere on the drawing board, you will see that this scale will remain parallel to original settings. So this is the advantage of this mini drafter. Variety of removable scales can be used as per the requirements. Horizontal, vertical, inclined, parallel and perpendicular line we can draw with the help of mini drafters. And commonly used by students and draftsmen for drawing the manual drawing, this mini drafter is used. Friends, now I will conclude this session. That here I will introduce my team, subject experts, then introduce different topics in this subject, basic engineering drawing. Then also I have given the introduction of subject, different topics. Then also I have given some terminology, theory of projections, projection methods, then drawing entities, and the competency which can be achieved with the help of engineering, studying the engineering drawing, that I have explained. We have started first topic, engineering drawing aids, and in that aids, I have given the list of different drawing material, instruments and equipments, and I have described in detail the description and use of drawing boards and mini drafters. Then in later on, in next session, I will continue from these points. Friends, I hope that you will get good awareness and advantage during these topics. I will try to show you the animated movies how to use these instruments. Thank you very much to all of you.